I feel as though the last several weeks in particular, we record this, excuse me, on a Tuesday, and it appears as though it just has a feeling as though I'm reporting a late night baseball score the next morning when I give these USC scores. Like, there's got to be a portion of the folks out there that are like, oh, USC, okay, who they play last weekend? What was the score? Like, I'm reporting this to a number of people or something.
Well, you know, that's a great image to plant for our viewing audience here on the Voice of College Football, because you and I are both old enough that we grew up in the age of the newspaper box score. Like, that's how we found out about those baseball games from the West Coast late at night. And USC really is a 1980s baseball game involving a mediocre team. Like, you don't even know who's playing or if the game even matters. You know, it's just kind of one of those things you learn in passing, because why would you want to stay up to watch USC football this season? Why would you want to watch a bad team that now is without Drake London? You know, the one really good reason to watch this team, it's just limping to the finish line. And so here's the anecdote I got to share with you and your audience about the USC Arizona State game from Saturday. Kent Somers, great columnist, longtime reporter for the Arizona Republic, one of the deans of Phoenix, you know, Phoenix area sports writing, covering the ASU Sun Devils in Tempe. He noted that fans were leaving midway through the second half, and that game was a 17-16 game. It was a one-point game. This was supposed to be the big rivalry in the Pac-12 South, the game that decided the Pac-12 South title, or at least had a major hand in shaping that race. And here we are in early November, USC down 17-16, a tight game for once. So this was finally a game in which the fourth quarter was purely in terms of the win-loss outcome. It was a dramatic game, and yet fans were leaving because they saw it was such a bad football game. This was a pillow fight. You know, two teams that are both kind of, they weren't necessarily drifting through the motions, but just it was bad quality. Like, the hitting was, you know, very weak, and you didn't have the level of performance, the level of excellence, the level of precision. You know, these were two football teams, and they did all the things that football teams did, but without any force, without any impact. You know, this was a pillow fight game, and fans could see it. I mean, and hey, if you were going to the stadium and then you left midway through the second half, like, what were you expecting, right? What were you expecting, a high quality football game here? So it's really a verdict on USC, also Arizona State, which looks very bad under Herm Edwards, who's, you know, not likely to survive for another season. This is likely going to be it for him. So it's just two teams, you know, if that playing out the string vibe. Players weren't really quitting. You know, they were making an effort, but they're not well coached. They're not well motivated. You know, it was just a limp, wet rag of a football game, and it's just part of this depressing USC season, which, you know, just no game outcome is going to stir a really rousing reaction from the fan base. It's all about the coaching search. It's all about who comes in to clean up this mess, and a mess which just gets worse with each passing week. That's the reality on the ground at USC.
I know a few weeks ago when Kansas was turning in that improbable three quarters against Oklahoma and they led 17-7 late in the third quarter, that there were reports that, you know, you can imagine what the attendance was for this game, but that they were opening the gates and people were actually showing up just for free football because they wanted to see something historic. And that, so this was the exact opposite of that. We had a close game against two teams that are recognizable in brand and image, and you would expect, oh, this is a good game. No, people are leaving even at 17-16. And this is with Arizona State now 6-3 and 4-2 in the conference, but little chance of catching Utah for first place because they're down a game, plus obviously the tiebreaker, basically down two games with only three to play.
That's right. And Utah has Arizona and Colorado easy wins on the schedule. So yeah, Arizona State's chances are nil. And so ASU can't win 10 games. You know, best ASU can do is 9-3. Can't win the division. Those were both central goals for the program, so it's already seen as a failure, and that's part of why Arizona State fans have joined USC fans in the checkout brigade. They've already checked out of this season. Just gotta love it. And they also want a new coach, a new way of doing things. So USC and ASU are very closely linked in that regard.